Hello everyone, welcome you all. Today we are going to learn about the mechanical methods of integrated pest management. In last lecture we have been seen about the cultural methods of IPM. In that cultural methods we will discuss on the various regular farm operation which will be used by the farmers in their farm to reduce the pest population. In today's lecture, we are going to learn the which are the different mechanical practices that will help to the farmers to reduce the pest population in their field. Here in this slide, you can see these are the different tools or methods of integrated pest management. Farmers, you can use these all tools to reduce the pest population in their fields. In last lecture, we have seen about the cultural methods, and in today's lecture, we will learn about the mechanical methods or mechanical practices of IPM. Let us see what is meant by mechanical methods. Here, this is the one of the against the eco-friendly methods of the integrated pest management. The cultural methods is also one of the effective eco-friendly methods of pest management. So now, what is meant by mechanical control or mechanical methods? Here, in that mechanical control, we can use a different mechanical force or manual labors either for destruction or exclusion of the pest. It means that to reduce the pest population with the help of mechanical practices or mechanical methods. In that methods, we can use the different mechanical force, or we can remove and destruct or destroy the different life stages of the insects by manual labor or by manually. Okay, what is the objective of mechanical methods? The objective, it is very simple, is that to eliminate the different life stages of insects pest, that is eggs, larva, pupa, adult and nymph also. Okay, it means that we can remove the different life stages of insect pests which are present in our field, and we can collect it and destroy in our own way. This is the simple and eco-friendly methods of mechanical control we can use in IPM technique. So let us start one by one, which are the different major practices we can employ or we can use or followed in mechanical control. Here this slide shows these are the three different major practices we can follow in mechanical control. In that, the first one is hand picking life stages of insects and their destruction. Then mechanical exclusion or provision of preventive barriers to prevent the pest infestation, and use of mechanical devices to attack the adult pest population. To attract the adult pest population. Let us see one by one. Here, this is the first major practice or mechanical practice. In that, the hand picking of life stages of insect and their destruction. What happened here? What is the main role of this hand picking? Here, this method already employed in that insect regarding the insects are pick out and destroy from the crops, and this method is applied when the insects are in a large number and easily accessible to picker. It means that when the number of population or the population of the insect it is large, then we can go for the hand picking and destruction of different life stages of the insects. In that, there are near about the seven practices we can follow to reduce the pest population in our field. The first one is by use of hand nets, then hand picking, by use of iron hook, beating with brooms, shaking of plants, sieving and winnowing, and rope dragging. These are the seven practices we can follow for destruction of life stages of the insects or by simply hand picking. Let us start one by one. This is the first practice, that is the hand picking and destruction of life stages. In this picture you can see the labor or the farmers, it will be collect the different life stages of the insects. It may be larva, egg masses or adult or nymph from the infested fields, and collect it and destroy in kerosene water or in the simply pesticide solution. Okay, this method we can use in the field if the insect in the field can be hand picked, if they are, और इजीली एक्सेसिबल टू द फिकर और द लार्ज नंबर ऑफ द पॉपुलेशन इज देयर। देन हेयर इन दिस स्लाइड यू कैन सी हेयर द रिमूवल ऑफ एग मासेस एंड लार्वल हैचिंग। इट मीन्स दैट वेन द इंसेक्ट पेस्ट आर ले देयर एग्स इन दैट आफ्टर दैट नियर अबाउट 3 to 4 days रिक्वायर फॉर देयर हैचिंग। We can remove this hatching, it is effective to control the or to reduce the next infestation of that particular pest. Then in second picture, we can see the labors collect the different larval instar of the Helicorp armigera from sunflower crop to reduce their infestation. This method is recommended to collect and destroy the egg masses of rice stem borer, larvae of the leaf-eating caterpillar and hairy caterpillar in their early stage, and also spingid semilupar larvae in their grown-up stage. Larvae of the mustard sawfly on radish and adults of the Epilacna beetles on brinjal and cucurbits also we can pick out, or we can pick out the different life stages of this all the insect, and we can destroy it in our own way. Then second practice is by use of hand net. This is the insect collection net. It is very useful to collect the flying insects like a butterfly, moths and grasshoppers. With the help of this hand collection net or insect collection net, we can collect this flying insect and we can kill it in kerosinated water. Then next practice is by use of iron hook. It is only simple hook which is made up or metal which is made up from the metal or the iron. This hook, it is specially used to kill the grub of mango stem borer and the adult of the rhinoceros beetle. The mango stem borer, it is the major pest of the mango, and the grub of the mango stem borer which is present inside the stem or branches by making a hole. With the help of this iron hook, we can insert this iron hook in that hole and it will be kill the grub which is present inside the stem. Then next, it is a rhinoceros beetle. It is a major pest of a coconut. This rhinoceros beetle which is present at the top of the coconut tree by making a small hole, and it is feeding in the inner side of that coconut plant. With the help of this iron hook, we can insert this iron hook in that hole and we can destroy the adult stage of the rhinoceros beetle in the coconut. Then next practice is beating with brooms. Brooms is nothing but the one of the thorny branches or thorny sticks. With the help of this broom or thorny branches or we can destroy the or we can hit the different stages of the locust and grasshopper also. It means that this technique, it is followed only in case of to kill the grasshoppers and locust only. Then next practice is shaking off host plant or adult host plant. Here the adult host plant, it means that in this picture we can see this is the white grub, this is the adult of the white grub. And this adult of the white grub, it is one of the nocturnal beetle, and that beetle which is present on the different trees, present in our field burn. The trees may be neem, bear, bel, babur, shauga, tamarind, bel, etc. It means that these are the different trees is act as a adult host trees for the adult of the white grub. And on that, these different trees, the beetles or the adult beetles, it may be male or female, which they will feed in a during night hours or in a night time. What happen in this practices, we can shake out or we can shaking these different adult host trees and collect the beetles which is fall on the grounds, and that beetles we can collect and destroy in the kerosinated water. This is the simple techniques. This techniques is also used for to remove the larvae of the Helicorp armigera on the red gram plants. Here in this picture we can see the labors shaking the red gram plants and collect the larvae of the Helicorp armigera with the flowers, and it will be destroyed in our own way. Then next practice is sieving and winnowing. This sieving and winnowing techniques, it is practice employed by the farmer from ancient time. And this practice, it should be followed by the farmer after the harvesting of that particular crop. And this technique helps to reduce the insect pest population of store grain pest or store grain products. Okay, here in this picture we can see with sieving and winnowing techniques employed by the laborers or the farmers in their own fields, and this technique it will be helps to reduce the different store grain pests like weevils, beetles or any other store grain insects in their store products. Then this is the another next practice, name is rope dragging. This practice it is mainly followed in a rice. The rope dragging or passing of rope across the rice crop to dislodge case worm over the standing water, which then drain out to collect the pest at the corner of the field. It means that this rope dragging practice it is followed in rice to reduce the pest population. The name of the pest is case worm. Then second major practice is mechanical exclusion or provision of the preventive barriers to prevent the pest infestation. Okay, it means that here we can destroy the pest population with the help of various barriers or mechanical exclusion. In that there are the near about the 8 practices we can follow to reduce the pest population. The first is a collar around the plant, then tin bands, then sticky bands or sticky traps, then trenches around the field, then bagging of fruits, use of iron pans, then screening of houses and bird scatter. Let us see one by one. This is first practice of mechanical exclusion, that is use of collar around the plant. Collar, it means that this is nothing but the one of the, we can say that the with the help of the plastic or the, we can say that the copper impregnated material which is around or make the one barriers around the stem of the plant just above the ground level or just ground level. What happen here? The plastic collar will form a reservoir to reduce the runoff and prevent the snail from the reaching the tomato crops. Okay. Then next, made from the copper impregnated material which helps to repel the slugs and to deter the cabbage root maggots. And this practice is also followed in potato and tobacco crop also to reduce the attack of cutworm. Next practice is use of tin bands. In this picture, we can see the laborers just fix the tin bands. Tin bands mean it is a metallic bands or metallic, just we can say that the bands which is fixed over the trees. Especially this practice is followed to reduce the infestation of the rats in a coconut tree. Hence the laborers just fix the metallic bands on the stem just above the ground level to reduce or to prevent the rat damage in that coconut plantation. Okay. Next one is use of sticky bands. In this picture we can see various sticky bands we can use by the farmers to prevent the pest population such as mealybugs. The application of greasy band of slippery sheets like alkathines around the trunk of mango tree or wrapping up trunk of mango trees with oily cloth to prevent the upward movement of the mango mealybug. It means that simply you can use alkathine sheets or we can use a grease or we can use any oils which is we can fix or which apply on the surface of the tree trunk to prevent the mealybug infestation in the mango or in any other crop. The next is trenches around the fields. This practice mainly followed in case of groundnut crop and rice crop. In groundnut, we can dig out the trenches near about the 30 to 60 cm deep and 60 cm wide around the groundnut or rice field. In rice fields, it helps to avoid the rice armyworm infestation, and in groundnut field, this practice will helps to prevent the red hairy caterpillar infestation or migration of these two pests. Next practice is bagging of fruits. The name itself indicates that this practice only followed in the horticultural fruit crops. Here in this picture you can see pomegranate, guava, apple and in mango, with the help of polythene paper or paper bags, simply we can wrapping this all or each and individual fruits with the help of this paper bag or polythene bags to reduce the attack of, especially in case of citrus and in case of pomegranate, to reduce the attack of fruit sucking moth. The fruit sucking moth, it is a major pest of the citrus crop and the pomegranate crop. It will damage the fruits and the fruits become rotten. Then also this practice followed in other fruit crop also to prevent from the heavy sunlight. Okay. Then use of iron pans. This ant pans, it is usually followed in beekeeping. Beekeeping, it is one of the major practice for the raiding of the different species of the honeybee for the profitable production of the different bee products. During beekeeping, the ants, it is very we can say they are the natural enemies of the bee colony that will damage in the that bee colony or beehive. Hence, this practice or we can say that the use of the four leg racks in vessels containing the water to prevent from the ants in the beekeeping practices. Then next one is screening of houses. Screening of windows and doors, etc. to prevent the mosquito and flies also. It means that this practice we can follow in our home also to prevent from mosquito and flies. This technique also followed in case of godowns and warehouses or ventilators of the warehouses and godowns are helpful to alert of the store grain pest. Then this practice is also followed in case of a silkworm rearing room to prevent from their natural enemies also. Then next practice is bird scarer. What is bird scarer? The bird scarer, it is nothing but the one of the device used for scaring away the birds by means of explosive sound is called as bird scarer. With the help of sound techniques, we can repel the birds from our field. This instrument is called as, or the device is called as a bird scarer. There are the number of the bird scarers is present. In that first picture, we can see this is the traditional bird scarer. This traditional bird scarer, it is used by the farmers from ancient way or ancient time to repel the birds. Then next one is a solar bird scarer. With the help of this solar energy, these bird scarers produce the we can say they are the sounds, and with the help of the sound that will help to reduce the or that will help to repel the birds. Then next one is acetylene gas bird scarer is also okay. Then next and last third major practice of the mechanical control is that use of mechanical devices to attract the different adult pest population. Mechanical devices, it means that there are the number of traps is used in that. The first one is light trap, then is experiment trap, air suction trap, and use of flamethrower. These are the different traps we can use to reduce the pest population in our field. Then this is the first light trap. This is a simple technique we can use to collect the different adult stages of the nocturnal insects. This light trap, which will be on in our field from 6 to 9 p.m., it will help to attract the different adults of the nocturnal insect, and it is collect into the bags, which is we can say that the present in the at the bottom of the that light trap, and we can collect these different adults, and it will be kill by our own way or in a kerosene water. For example, installation of light trap, it is recommended for mass trapping to killing of pillworm in the tomato. Okay, then this is the air suction trap, and in this picture you can see this is the pitfall trap and the insect probe trap. This insect probe trap and pitfall trap, it is specially used to kill the store grain pest, and the air suction trap, it is installed in the godowns. Again, different store grain pest also we can use. Then this is the flamethrower. This is another mechanical device. This flamethrower, it is specially used to kill the different adult or hoppers of the locust. Then this one is a rodent trap. This rodent trap nowadays specially used in the warehouses or in the we can say that the godowns to catch or to pick the different rodent species, and it will be killed. Then, which are the different merits and demerits of the mechanical control? Here, this mechanical control, it is environmentally safe because it is eco-friendly methods. They are economically good and generally popular, and it is more useful in highly pest populated areas. Okay. Then, what is the demerits? It require more time to get results. That is, it is time to consuming methods. It means that the time is very more required to kill the different pest population. Okay. This is all about the different mechanical practices we can follow in our field to reduce the pest population by means of mechanical way or manual, with the help of manual labor. Thank you.